Hi friends, my name is Bharat D, URK20CS2113, and today we are going to see file handling in object oriented programming lab session 9th record. And this is the compulsory question: perform the following operation on the file using menu driven application. Let's see how I have done the code for that. First, I've created this is the code for the following program. I've created a package experiment number 9. I've imported Java because of the scanner function. In the public class, I've created a class named practice. And a public static void main throws IO exception, and while it is true, while the function is true, it creates a menu driven function like opening an existing file, creating a new file, renaming a file, deleting a file, creating a directory, finding an absolute path of the file. These are the menu driven options here. You need to enter a choice. The user get to enter a choice and checks if the choice equal to equal one, and check, and given the file location of my file which I've given here, and in the integer I've given system outprint, enter the file name with extension. The user needs to enter the file name with extension afterwards, where the file is equal to new file, the location of the file plus the file name. The file content is, it prints out the what is the content in the file, and here we have a printout statement and catch exception, and the printout statement here, and gives the same location is also given here, and here it enters the file name with exception, and after this function runs, it prints out the file is created successfully. Else if the enter the odd file name with extension, it prints that. Otherwise, if the file is not created successfully, and if it exists one, f1 exists one, it enters a new file with an extension, where file f2 is equal to new file location plus new file, and renames the file name. And finally, the file name renamed successfully, and it print out there is no file with this name, because the name has been renamed. Then we have the fourth choice, like enter the file name with extension. Here it prints file. If f1 is equal to new file location, and if f1 exits, it deletes, and the file deleted successfully. Else there is no file with this name. The choice 5, the same location is being given. Enter the directory name, where we need to create a small file like structure, where the system directory created successfully. It prints out directory is not created. Else we have given the same location, enter the file name with extension here, where the new file is equal to file location, and the file name if f exists, it prints file's absolute path. Otherwise, it prints there is no file with this name, and here's the choice, the same the choice 7 is the same location I've given here, files and directories. It prints out the whole list of things what you have done here. And after all the choices are finished, the final one is the exit one. It prints out see you later. Otherwise, if you did not enter any of these following options here, it prints out wrong input and finishes the program. This is how the program is done. Now let's run the program. You can see the following function has been done correctly. Now let's enter a choice. First we'll opening an existing file, because I've already done opened an existing file. Now let's enter the name of that. I've given as to snow.txt. Now let's give enter. And the file contains Jon Snow is the king in the north, and it asks enter your choice. Now let's enter the second choice. The second choice is enter the file name with extension. Now let's enter the file name with extension, file underscore File has been created successfully. Let's see whether the file has been created successfully. File for creation has been successfully created. Now let's enter the choice 3. Enter the old file with name of extension. This is the same name here. A new name with, we'll give it as file underscore form rename, for underscore rename dot txt. File renamed successfully. Let's see whether it's renamed. Yeah, you can see the file name has been renamed here. File for rename here, it's been renamed. Now let's do our next choice. Let's enter deleting a file. It'll give us 4. The file has been deleted successfully. We'll give the chance 4. Enter the file name. We'll delete the renamed file. Let's see whether this name is still there. See, you can see the renamed file has been deleted. This is how the program is done. Now let's see. Now let's make it as something. We'll give it as it's, we'll give it as November. MB, yeah. November. I've created a dictionary called November and it's been created. Now let's enter the choice. Now let's give 7. We'll give the absolute path. Enter the file with extension. It is. You can see the things, the file's absolute path is being given here, the location of the path. Now let's give option 7. Enter the choice. See, after you enter your choice 7, file directories, whatever the works you have done has been given here. Now let's exit the program. This is how the program is done. Now we'll go to the second question. The second question given for me is create a function in Java to count the number of embedded white spaces and punctuations present in the text file named sample.txt. I've already created a text file named sample.txt. Now let's see the code for this. First, I've created a package named experiment number 9. I've imported Java for the scanner function, and I've given a public class is question 2, where the public static void throws an exception, and file input streams a new file, and I've given the location where the file sample txt has been located. I've initialized, and the count is equal to 0, and if is read, and if I gets incremented minus 1, the character is equal to character, then these semicolon, etc., comma are the embedded devices, white spaces, which are going to come into considerations while I gets decremented for close, where the subject, it prints embedded white spaces and punctuations plus count, and it prints out if the file is not, if the location is not accurate or not correct, it prints out file not found. Now let's run this program. The embedded white spaces and punctuations are 3. What I've been given is, here is the sample text. I've given my name is Prince. This is the Question, this is the notepad I've been used here. The embedded devices and white spaces are 3. Thank you, friends. This is how this program is done.